Ready, steady, go.
Good morning. Today, my colleague Maracano spawn your topic of esas key aparel.
I'm happy to be here. I'm glad to have this opportunity to talk to you about esas aparel. But first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Maracano, and I come from the Luther School of Art, where I study design of artistic jewelry. I have chosen to speak about SS Aparel jewels because I like the clothes design, accessories, and of course, hair jewelry bracelets. I will not speak about hair fashion design. I have limited my speech to hair jewelry design. You may interrupt me at any moment to a question or make comments, okay? I'm so grateful to Pedro, the English teacher, for his help and advice. This is the part of my work. I have divided my presentation into three parts. In the first part, I give some personal details about SS Aparel. In the next section, I explain and show some of her different jewelry design. And in part three, I show other designs such as button and buckets. There will be plenty of time at the end of my pitch for questions and discussions. Not many people know that when she was a little girl, she had the feeling that she was a green shoulder. She planted seeds in her nose a month to grow beautiful flowers that would have healed her face. It says Keperi, or Eskia, as she was now, was a fashion designer with ahead of her time, born in Rome in 1819. She was influenced by the Italian Futurist movement, Parisian folk, and the Cubists. Her creation and market surrealist compute in faith and historical importance with those of Coco Chanel. Her models were considered daring and surprising to the canon of his time. Many of them include an extravagant item such as a showstopper, hot, or printed airplane lasters. She got a lot of inspiration from the surrealist movement, dealing with artists like Jean Cocteau and especially Salvador Dalí, with whom he collaborated on several projects whose iconography were adapted to their models. In the early 1920s, jewelry design radically changed from creating pieces with precious stone to using crystal and enamel. Costume jewelry became popular and Schiavelli raised the bar. She believed that using fake or as they call it, young jewelry, imitation jewelry, she could be more creative in her designs. The natural beauty of jewelry with precious stone requires skill in combination with imitation jewelry. Junk jewelry permits women to reveal their personality. Her jewelry line went from precious to crystal and rhinestone. She played with untraditional materials such as China porcelain, glass, crystal, aluminium, and plastic. One example of this can be the insect necklace. desert image of brush, some items that add fly, luster, and heart are repeated in the collection of jewelry, cloth, and accessories. Here you can find different models of earrings, including David's telephone, hearing for jewelry. Here you can find some extraordinary bracelets inspired by the seas and ocean. One of them is decorated with fox seals and pearls with a splash of aquamarine colors. Her jewelry design probably began with the fasteners she designed for the clothes, buckles, holes, zipper, and buttons. She believed that the pattern were boring. So she transformed it into a small sculpture, like buttons, shapes, like insects, piano, shoelace, snail, tops, padlocks, nuts and bolts, coffee beans, lollipops, peanuts, corn, fruits and vegetables. She worked with other artists, Jean Tremain, Albert Giacometti, or Jan Slenberger, to design wooden, cellulite, glass, crystal,